Hello and welcome to Mastering the Sum Formula in Excel. Today we'll explore the powerful capabilities of the sum formula in Microsoft Excel. In this video, we'll cover the fundamentals of using sum to perform quick and accurate calculations on numerical data. This video is divided into three parts. Part 1 is understanding the sum formula, Part 2 is using the sum formula, and part 3 are the common mistakes that we make while using this formula. The syntax, which is how this formula is to be written, is sum within brackets number 1, comma number 2, comma number 3, and so on and so forth, where number 1 can be an actual number like 5, a cell reference like A3, or a range like A3 to A8. The most basic use of sum function is that it adds numbers. If you need to add two or more numbers, simply use is equal to sum, press tab to get the brackets automatically, and let's say we have to add 4, 5 and 9. So we'll type 4, comma 5, comma 9, close the brackets, press enter, and it will give you the total as 18. However, it can do a lot more. Like in this case here, where we have a data which has about 21 rows and 7 columns. Now we'll use this in part 2 of this video on how to use the sum formula. What we have here is a basic expense data of a company neatly entered against each employee name and the month it is for. What we want to do is we want to find how much expense has an employee claimed altogether in the given period and what is our monthly total for all employees in a given month. Let's start with writing our formula to total the first column in cell B22. One way to do it is that we can add individual columns like this. And then we do plus, we do this, plus, plus, and it'll give you the total, but as you can see, it is very time consuming. So if we have to add all these numbers in the most efficient way, we use the sum function. So here we've got our cell B22 highlighted and we'll use the sum function is equal to sum tab and we simply select the whole range like this. Close the brackets, press enter, and we've got the total. Now, let's copy this to all these columns here, and we'll have the total for all of these columns. Now we have the total of all the months. What we need to do is we need to find against each employees as well. So let's do the same, is equal to sum, open brackets, and select the whole row, press enter, and we've got the total for this employee for the whole period starting from January of 2022 to July of 2022. Now let's copy this and paste it till the end. And here we have it. We've got the total for each month and we've got the total for each employee. Excel calculates the sum of the selected cells and displays the result in the designated cell. In this case, this is the designated cell. This method is really handy when you need to calculate the sum of a few cells. Now here's a bonus tip. Let's say we want to calculate the total for all the employees for all these months. You can do that with sum as well. Let's say we want to do a grand total. So we are going to write a formula is equal to sum tab, and then we'll select the whole range up till here. Press enter and we've got the total. Another bonus tip. Let's say we want to calculate total for all employees, but let's just say for 2 or more months. Let's say we need to see our total for the months of January, April and July 2022. So what we are going to do is, let's type our heading here, January, April and July, and we'll write our formula as sum tab and select January, comma, April, comma, July. Close the brackets, press enter, and here we've got the total for January, April, July 2022 for all the employees. Now that we know how to use the sum function, we should be aware of the most common limitation and human error while using it. The most common human error is when instead of a number, something else is entered in the cell. Let me show you with an example. We'll use the same expense report over here and we'll copy it to another sheet in the same workbook like this. And we'll change a numeric value to something else. Let's say this employee over here, he was on vacation in January 2022. So we've got only vacation mentioned in his expense report. Keep a close watch what happens the moment I press enter. And there you can see that the total here has been changed. Let's see that again. Control Z and we do vacation. Before we press enter, make a note that it's $38,831. The moment I press enter, it's down to $31,672. Now this could be beneficial in some cases where it is deliberate, but we need to be sure that the data we are working with is actually what we need. To check if your cell has any letters instead of numbers, instead of going through all the cells one by one, remember this sheet can have tens of thousands of rows and columns, so that's not possible in all the cases. Over here it's a simple table where we can see that there's one cell which has vacation on it. So the easiest way is to use filters. What we are going to do here is we'll highlight the first row. And then we'll use Control Shift L to enable the filters. For Mac users, it'll be Command Shift and L. Here we go. Now the way Excel sorts the characters in the cell, it's numbers first, alphabets after that. Let's see here. In January, we've got all the numbers. They're all mentioned here, right? And then in April, again, all the numbers. But what happens when we check June 22? You see numbers, numbers, and at the end, you'll see vacation. So if there are letters in any of these cells, that'll be at the end of your filters. So we'll cancel this out. That's the most common mistake that I've seen while using the sum function. So now you've mastered the sum formula in Excel. With its versatility and ability to handle various arguments, you can effortlessly perform complex calculations on your data. Remember, Excel offers numerous other formulas and functions to explore, but understanding the sum formula is an essential step towards unleashing the full potential of this powerful spreadsheet software. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. You can find more videos explaining such functions and more on our channel every week and we upload these videos in English, Hindi, Urdu, Spanish, and French. Thank you.